It starts raining and I got lost, and then I hit this pole sticking right out of the ground in the middle of the fucking sidewalk. And I went into the business. It was a restaurant, and my legs all gashed open and bleeding. So I'm walking past these customers all bloody and whatnot. And I finally find the guy working there, and he cleaned out my cut and then tried to send me to the hospital. But I thought it was a better idea to come to your house and document the process of what happens when you cut your leg and you gotta try to get it fixed.
Yeah?
Yep.
No hace falta que salga la luna pa' venirte a cantar mi canción. Ni hace falta que el cielo esté lindo pa' venir a entregarte mi amor. No encontré las palabras precisas pa' decirte con mucha pasión que te quiero con toda mi vida, que soy un esclavo de tu corazón. Solo Dios, que me vio en mi amargura, supo darme consuelo en tu amor y mandó para mí tu ternura, y así con tus besos borró mi dolor.
To get out of there, and it started raining again, so I climbed up this weird spiral staircase that goes to the top of a climbing wall and looks over the city, and then smoked a bunch of weed with these dudes. Came back down the weird spiral case like an hour later, and the whole city was like fucking River City. And then cut myself.
Feet up?
Yeah.
It's gonna hurt for that, huh?
Thank you so much.
It's gonna stain, right?
Yeah.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. It's just skin, that's not the bone, but you still need stitches. By the way, I'm a nurse, man. You're lucky.
I'm super lucky.
Sort of. Okay, so what you're gonna do is, we have a little hospital here. Do you have any money?
I have some, yeah.
They're gonna charge you like about 150 pesos.
I'm getting a little lightheaded.
Just the sugar barrel.
I feel like I might pass out.
Let me get some comfort. Just drink it all the way.
Turo, I just slashed over my leg.
Okay.
There's an Uber waiting out front. I need you to help me document this. We're rolling.
You ready?
Yeah.
Sorry.
I need some juice. But my.
Okay, let's go, dude.
Blood sugar level.
All right.
Perdón
por la demora, no tengo idea, Soy un ignorante de lo de los hospitales.
I was just barely trying to stay conscious. I kept fucking passing out, and I was like, I hope I don't pass out before I find the house. Because then he'd just be driving around with this dude passed out in the middle of his Uber ride, which would be weird.
The Uber here is new, really. Él lo sabe español y él lo sabe en inglés. Tengo que ser el intermediario. He gonna leave?
Yeah.
Or you want to he wait?
Oh, is this the hospital?
Yeah.
70,
yeah, 70, right. 70, ¿verdad?
Cuídese que esté bien.
Gracias, gracias. Thank you. I couldn't find my wallet and then I realized it was in my hand. Dude, I was just walking.
Perdón, estaba caminando.
Lo que haya sido, sí, se le lastimó.
Sí, ok.
Sí, viene lastimado.
Exacto. Queremos ver dónde se puede atender.
Vaya allá a las ventanillas.
Over there is like 4 or 5 blocks more up.
Okay.
Or we could wait. Okay, gracias. Just got to walk to another hospital.
We didn't get denied, but it would be a while, and my leg is still technically working, so I figure I might as well get a little more use out of it.
Right. I remember. It's down. Sorry.
I think the doc's about to come in. Let's turn this off.
And so where do I get the medicines and stuff?
Let me ask her, right? Ah, sí? Ah, okay. And whatever you want. ¿En serio? Your target is declined.
Oh, really? Right. My bandage is coming off here. Come get a closer look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. 7 stitches. And he did a pretty good job, I think, except for this thing keeps coming off. Whenever I do a surgery on the side, check out this bus. I love that shit. You see that shit? Why can't fucking all buses have lights and shit all over them letting you know they're coming and they're like festive and they care about driving instead of just like, oh, we have the same sticker as everybody else. No, if this guy, I saw a bus today, this guy said, nightmare ride. I mean, isn't that a fucking blast? You're going out shopping or something, gonna pick up some tomatoes and you take fucking nightmare ride to the grocery store or something? So we're gonna keep walking here and I'll give you a kind of a tour of Arturo's neighborhood. He lives just up from downtown here. I can only find it basically by finding the cathedral or this one bar where a guy tried to bust me for rolling cigarettes one time because he thought it was joints, and then they found him dismembered a year later with his wife somewhere out in the desert.
What? Whoa.
That's how I find your place. It's either this road or a famous bar that is famous for dismembering owners.
Oh,
and
shit.
Are we not supposed to say that? Have you ever made a documentary before that had a surgery in it?
No, never. I'm musical video guy.
A musical?
No short films guy.
Don't you think we can make a musical video out of this?
What? Was a different night, right?
It was different. I've never had an evening quite like this. And I didn't even get to tell the whole story because some dude just drove up in the... Open the door and I'll tell him the whole story. Some guy drove his car up in the middle of the street, stops in the middle of the street and says, "Are you going to the skate park?" I said, "Yeah." And he goes, "Jump in, I'll give you a ride. Don't worry, I'm a rollerblader."
Here?
Here, on the way to Palomar. So I got a ride on the middle of the street on the way there when it was completely sunny and I was happy. And then a fucking thunderstorm happens and all cars want to do is splash me and then I rip open my leg. So it's like a real roller coaster of the day here in Chihuahua.
Ando borracho, ando tomando, porque el destino cambió mi suerte. Ya tu cariño, nada me importa, mi corazón te olvidó pa' siempre. Fuiste en mi vida un sentimiento que destrozó toditita mi alma. Quise matarme por tu cariño, pero volví a recobrar la calma. Ñoño, que tanto lloré por tus besos. Ñoño, que siempre te hablé sin mentira. Hoy solo puedo brindarte desprecio. Ñoño, que tanto te quise en la vida.
Circo sí, pero sin animales.
Circo sí, pero sin animales.
It is, man.
I can't read that, dude. It's in Spanish.
A pedir ayuda se lastimó la pierna. Es un chavo, un gringo.
Holy shit, they found a microphone. So I kind of want to try to extort this business and try to get some money out of them, at least the amount of money that I spent my 30 bucks back for the stitches, but Arturo thinks it's a bad idea, so maybe I won't do that. But I mean, I feel like I should at least tell him, hey, listen, this thing that you made, it's cutting people's legs. Maybe you should alter your plan here. This is maybe not the best way to get customers to cut their legs open. Okay, so we're here at the smokehouse restaurant, House of the Meat.
Sí, es mejor.
Yeah, make sure to thank Geraldo for me. He did a very good job and he really like cleaned it up well and it was very nice of you to help me, especially in a restaurant because I know it kind of freaked people out. Gracias, muchas gracias.
I've got my microphone that I left there because I passed out on the floor. And now we're going to go check out this little spike that cut me.
Ah, this thing?
That thing. Without the pull.
Well, my opinion,
yeah,
is I don't think that is an issue.
When it's dark, if you can't see, that's gonna cut you.
I don't think so, dude.
So we're gonna go talk to the business because the guy who works at the restaurant here, the smokehouse, also cut himself.
I give him my opinion, but when the guy told me,
he also cut himself.
Story, I understand.
Right. What happened to that guy?
No, he works here, and he happened something similar.
Tu metálico aquí es muy, muy peligroso para niños, para nosotros en la calle.
He says they don't have contact direct with the owner because they are from other. Is not de aquí?
No.
It's not from here.
Is it a sin? Is it your sign or no?
Que si es de ustedes.
Sí, la bandera sí es de nosotros.
Ajá. Sí, that's what color. El,
yeah, it's from here.
Right.
Pero sí, el local ya tenía las ranuras. Antes había otro negocio y tenían una bandera de ese tipo.
They say they rent here.
Uh-huh.
They know the owners.
That's fine, but I'm going to let people know you shouldn't shop at this store because this store cuts people's fucking legs.
Okay, okay.
unless they want to pay for the stitches, because I shouldn't have to pay for their sign cutting my leg. That's fucked up.
Que le recompensen el gasto, pero que si no pueden, él va a quemar el lugar con los
social media.
Social media. Dice que porque ahí cortan piernas, ¿me explico? Por decirlo así, in that way, en esa forma.
Sí.
Dice que él no va a decir nada si le remuneran. Okay, some of the money or all the money?
For the stitches, all of it, 700 pesos.
Okay, todo el dinero por el de este, digo, perdón, por el corte, o...
If I pay, I'm going to tell everyone, don't ever come here. These people will cut you and they don't care. If they pay, I'll say, hey, it was my mistake.
Porque cortan piernas. Bueno, exagerado, pero algo así.
Sí. I need the contact information from the owner.
De la misma de colores.
Ay, Arturo, ¿cómo estás?
Más que no todo.
¿Tu familia cómo está?
Bien, por aquí.
¿En serio?
Owner's name and telephone
¿Tienes
number?
El nombre del propietario?
No.
You don't have the name of the person who owns the business?
No.
Aluminovia will slice your leg open. Don't shop here. It's just like that. Nah, just tried to extort some money out of this business over here, but it didn't work. That was my first Mexican extortion. And they don't know who the owner is. They send the payment electronically and they don't have his name of the owner of the business. So that's about as unsuccessful as you can get for extortion. But yeah, now we got another Uber to get back to the house and then get the drugs.
¿De dónde viene?
No, yo soy aquí. Y Jeff es gringo.
No, soy gabacho.
Gabachot.
Mejor, ¿no?
Bueno, es que hay una historia, supuestamente, según él dice, que es como una ofensa cuando dicen green, go. O sea, green like a militar.
Sí,
como militar.
Sí.
Es un insulto de...
Militar, pero... vamos. Es como gringo.
Es que yo tengo que dar la vuelta por acá, pues.
Got some antibiotics and painkillers. Paid 120 pesos, which... I'm not even going to do the calculation on that because it's like $6 or something. And I can say that it was really fun this time in Chihuahua. And if you've never been and you've only read it on the newspaper about horrific narco shit, don't worry about that shit because it doesn't happen to you unless you're in the game. So stay out of the game, bring your skateboard, buy some paintings from Arturo, and don't lacerate yourself. But if you do lacerate your leg, you know, it's not a really big deal. You pay your $30 and you know you're back on your way.
Some of the points are in the skin. I've just got
two of them
back to Seattle now. I don't know, it looks okay. What do you think?
Very flat, it looks great. The color looks great, so it's time to remove these points. I told Jeff it's time to do it, and he's like, oh, it's okay, blah, blah.
As my Mexican extortion went terribly, I didn't get any money at all. Now I'm the company who had put this flagpole thing up that sliced open my leg, and they refused to change it, they refused to pay for my stitches, they refused to do anything. So the first thing I was going to do was take the medical documents here and go ahead and post them online. I wanted everybody to just see legitimately exactly what I went through. However, when I looked at the documents I received, my birth date is incorrect, my name is incorrect, my sex is incorrect. I mean, by now, I don't think that they're going to give me any money back for the stitches, but I want to make them lose some business because they're cutting people, and maybe I can't get any money, but maybe I can harass them into changing this so that, like, old people and kids aren't, like, slicing their legs in front of the store. And maybe, I don't know, maybe they'll send people after me.
I will go to tell them, do you see these motherfuckers? This is for you. So they should have at least give me, like... minimum $10,000.
$10,000?
But yeah!
I tried to extort $40 and I was unsuccessful.
Okay.
$40, they were like, well, no way, that's extreme. So there you go. If you need to take out your own stitches, you can do it at home. It's not hard.
But, well, no, I don't know. I mean, I didn't do
that.
It. I didn't do it. Okay.
Don't say that.
Okay, I can't say it's not hard because I didn't actually do it. But you can see that it's doable and you can sterilize your equipment right in the kitchen. If that's all you have, if that's all you have, it's going to be better than nothing.
Don't encourage people doing that. If you don't know how where to cut the points, you can cut yourself. So don't do this at home. Just go to the hospital or go to your private doctor and let them to do their work. Anyway,
there you have it.
Okay.
Just like she said, feel free to do it at home. It's totally safe. You don't need medical knowledge.
I didn't say that.
Hey,
somebody.